I want to do a quick bonus video here about the custom order weapons that you can get from Nimble. I said I was going to do this later on in the LP, earlier in the LP, but I didn't really actually do it because I tend to forget about it. I mean, Nimble's all the way up here, all alone in his corner of the ship. Anyway, I'm going to get it done now. I've got a whole lot of money.
Order complete.
And I'm probably still going to have to get some artifacts to sell the beard later on to cover all of it, but should hopefully be worth it. So I'm going to start with close quarters weapons. Basically, you pay him a down payment, you sleep for about a full day, maybe a little more, and then you can come back and you pay the rest of it for the weapon that he gives you. If he gives you a weapon that you don't want, you have the option to tell him that you don't want it, and that's really only useful for the really expensive items, and if it gives you like a crappy one.
I'm listening.
He just gave us a shotgun we've already got, but if we said no, that we didn't want it, then we'd lose our down payment, and the next one would cost extra.
That's your order complete.
This weapon now that he's giving us, it's a Spaz 12 that's customized to have less recoil, so you can fire it on full auto without as much of a jump as there used to be, but it's not really that great, because you can just basically take it to a, I don't even know what to call them, an upgrader, and upgrade it to be a bit easier to control if you really have issues with that. So, drink a few bottles of vodka, because he's kind of shafting us right now on good items. Hopefully the next one will be good.
That's your order complete.
Now, you only have about 3 items you can get from each category from Nimble. Some of them will be good, some of them are going to be bad. The one that we just got is an upgraded MP5 that fires 45 caliber shells rather than 9mm shells, so it's a lot more powerful, but it is got a issue with muzzle climb.
I'm listening.
Now you can actually go to the upgraders and upgrade these custom weapons to be better, so you could reduce the recoil that you get from the MP5, but it's not really my preferred. So I'm going to move on into the assault weapons, which is the most useless tree of them all. I guess the assault weapons, they were kind of intending for you to do early in the game, but the problem with that is that they're expensive. So you're not going to have a whole lot of money, you're going to screw yourself with money if you wind up getting these early in the game. Now, I wouldn't say really any of these weapons is useful in terms of how much money you have to spend for it here. Especially if you consider how early on we got the SIG. So, the weapon that we could have gotten right now was the F2000. And it's basically the NATO equivalent of the Thunder in this game. It's not very good. You know, of course, you know, it's an in-game weapon, but
that's your order complete.
It's not going to be worth
collect
it.
Collect your
for
goods.
Us.
I'm listening.
So we got a G36. I think this is actually just a regular G36. I don't think he gives you any upgraded assault weapons, just regulars. Not really the best weapon. This is basically a step down from the F2000.
What are you? A statue? You got something, spill the beans.
Alright, what do you have for us this time, Nimble? I am going to show these weapons off. Just want to get a good amount before we head out, because it can be hard to find targets sometimes. Alright, so the weapon that we just got from him is the Thunder. Which I was just talking about. And the Thunder is not bad. It's got a high rate of fire, and it's basically... Nah. With a weapon, with the ammunition that the weapon has,
hey, bro.
It's got good accuracy and decent range, and it's supposed to have the firing rate of a submachine gun. It's also got a built-in grenade launcher, but that's not really too useful. And here you might recognize this guy as being the guy that gave us the quest to find the toolbox of stuff in that flipped over car. And he tried to take all of it when we brought it back to him. Now he's saying that the custom weapons that we have on us are his, and that they were stolen from him. If you choose to go down this path of this quest line, then it's just going to be really annoying and aggravating, so I'm not even going to bother with it. Basically just tell him to screw off and let that be that. If you want to keep going with it, then it basically winds up you chasing him into Yanov Station. He says he doesn't know what you're talking about. You leave the station, come back, and he's taken all of your stuff from your personal box. And I don't want to have to go through all the work to get that back, so I'm not going to bother. With a few upgrades, the Thunder could actually be an extremely good weapon if you like full auto fire. I don't, so I'm not really going to use it. Let's see if we can find a target right here for the MP5. Alright, this is taking too long. I'm just gonna cut to whenever we find somebody. Zombies always make good targets. So as you can see, there's quite a bit of muzzle climb, which makes this gun kind of difficult to use if you use full auto for it. It is decent for power, but it's not that great for us right now.
That's you.
Now I'm moving on to pistols, and this one, he's trying to. He basically gave us a compact, which is, I believe, P250 from SIG, and it's basically just got upgraded durability. Nothing really that special. Probably the least useful out of all the pistols he gives us. This one's not bad. An upgraded USP, which I believe has extra power and accuracy. And apparently used to belong to a guy called Wolfhound, who was in the first Stalker game. He was a mercenary leader in the area outside of the bar area. If you remember the first game, there was a downed helicopter where we had to escort a ecologist. It was actually right where you can find Gordon Freeman's body and get the Big Ben pistol. He led the mercenaries there on the attack. And you apparently kill him, and I guess in that game he actually didn't even have a USP on him. But anyway, as you can see, it's decently powerful for headshots. This is probably the best pistol out of all three of the ones that you can get. The next one we get, though, isn't bad. This is a Desert Eagle with increased accuracy. We'll check that out in a little bit, but first, some background information on Nimble. He's actually been in every single Stalker game in the series so far. He has been, in the first one, he was captured by bandits and gave you a quest to find armor. In the second one, he told us about our PDA in the Clear Sky Camp. And in this one, he obviously sells his weapons.
I'm listening.
Let's go test out the Desert Eagle here. Let's see how accurate it is, and kind of had some farther away enemies in mind. The damage speaks for itself. Not really all that effective against mutants if you can't even take out some blind dogs. I believe there's some zombies down the road here. The benefit of emissions happening so often is that there's a lot of zombies, which means that we have a lot of target practice, I guess, at least. And free loot. And just to note, I am low crouching, so this is the most accurate it's going to get. It's not bad for accuracy for a pistol, but I can do that much easier and much faster with my SIG.
We're complete.
Now I believe we've moved on to sniper rifles.
I'm listening.
Yeah, no pushing. Wait your turn.
Howdy ho!
Yes, sniper rifles. This is a second generation version of this sniper rifle. So it's got increased power and accuracy, I believe. It's definitely not my favorite sniper rifle. I think that as far as sniper rifles go, this is the least useful. It is the lightest, however, so that does say something if you don't have an exosuit. This next one is probably the most useful. Because this is actually the best sniper rifle in the game that we just got. It is a customized version of the sniper rifle that we've already got. And it's actually got, I think we'll take a look at the stats here in a second. So we'll compare it to the one that I've got right now. This is our current sniper rifle. This is a sniper rifle already here. So this one already has more damage, and it's got more accuracy. I believe its accuracy is actually maxed out. Or just about to be maxed out. In fact, the other one that we got is more, I think, more powerful than the one that we've got now. So let's go try these out and see just how the accuracy goes for it. Very articulate today. Bandits always make good targets.
This is Stalker. Skelos is under attack. We've been forced to batten down the hatches until things quiet down.
This is the most annoying feature of the game. They make it to where if you attack anybody within a certain distance of the safe houses, they'll lock down and you can't go inside of them, and all the Stalkers around them will attack you. So I'm definitely going to quick load because I don't feel like sitting out in an open field letting the game run for about 20 minutes while I wait for the base to unlock. So it's still a bit inaccurate. And the power, we had to hit that guy several times. Let's try out the new one. One shot in the body. That's not bad. Can't know if we hit that guy or not because of the reeds, but second shot definitely did it in. So I believe that I have found the new sniper.
Так, мужик, чего ж там у тебя?
Just gonna get a little bit of extra money to upgrade it. And let's take a look at the last one that we get. Sniper rifles are definitely the best category to buy stuff from.
Collect your goods.
It's got the most useful weapons. You don't have to order as many to get a useful one. And while they are more expensive, they are ultimately more worth it. Because you'll be using sniper rifles throughout the entire game unless you feel like spending 2,000... 2,000 rubles on 6 rounds for your Gauss rifle.
I'm listening.
And this one, it's basically your typical VSS. Except for the fact that it's got increased rate of fire, but it's still got a 10-round magazine. Not exactly the best combination. Power's definitely nice to have, though.
Возможно, еще не все.
Now, you might remember me using this weapon as the, I believe, my primary weapon for the first and second Stalker games. So it's definitely a good weapon that you can get. I wouldn't really use it as my sniper rifle, but it's good enough to really use as both, as long as you like single shots. So anyway, I fully upgraded the other sniper rifle, and as you can see from the stats, it's actually better. So we can say goodbye to the old model. I'm not going to bother with getting all the armor, because there's only one custom armor that he gives, and it's just some clear sky armor. It's not very good by any means. So I wouldn't really... not gonna waste my money on it. Wow. Actually got a lot of stuff at Yanov. Could you imagine me having to get all this stuff back after somebody stole it? No thanks. Anyway, I'm gonna switch out some equipment and I'm actually almost over encumbered. Wow. Kind of impressive. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching, guys. I will see you in the next part.